Vanilla. In this video, I'm going to talk about the voltage distribution across the discs of suspension insulators and string efficiency. For high voltage transmission, a string of suspension insulators is used so that the current from the conductors does not flow to the earth through towers. A suspension insulator consists of number of porcelain discs connected in series through metallic links. Yes, here the insulator disc is placed between two metal links. Now, let me ask you one question. What is the name of the device that is constructed using two metal plates separated by a non-conducting substance? Of course, it's a capacitor. The non-conducting substance can be any insulator or even air. Coming back to our suspension insulator, each disc acts as a capacitor. This is called self-capacitance. If you look carefully, you can notice that I have used the same capacitor value for all the self-capacitances. Do you think they'll have the same capacitances? Let's check it out. The capacitance can be found using the formula epsilon A by D. Here, epsilon refers to the permittivity of the dielectric material or the non-conducting substance. A refers to the area of the two metals and D refers to the distance between two metals. Generally, same sized insulators are used. Therefore, in all these cases, epsilon A and D remain the same. This means the capacitance value will be the same. Now, there is another capacitor hidden here. It's between the tower and the metal link. Here the dielectric material is air. This is called shunt-capacitance. Insulators are required to withstand both mechanical and electrical stresses. The electrical stress is mainly due to the line voltage and may cause the breakdown of the insulator. In order to find the amount of electrical stress experienced by each disc, we need to calculate the voltage across them. Let me give you an example. If the voltage across the disc is 3 kV, 10 kV and 20 kV, which one do you think will get punctured? The disc which experiences 20 kV electrical stress will get punctured. Instead, if the voltage is divided equally, then we can avoid the puncture. Now, let's find the voltages V1, V2 and V3 and analyze whether they are equal or not. To simplify, let's assume C2 by C1 as a constant K. Why is it constant? As I said earlier, capacitance is epsilon A by D. Here, the distance D and the area A are predetermined while designing the electrical tower itself and will be constant. Just imagine that the charging current is I. At node A, it gets splits into IA and I1. The current I1 splits into I2 and IB at node B. Again, the current I2 splits into IC and I3 at node C. Applying Kirchhoff's current law at nodes B and C, we get I1 is equal to IB plus I2 and I2 is equal to IC plus I3. We know that the current through the capacitance is equal to voltage divided by capacitive reactance. Capacitive reactance is 1 divided by omega C. Using this formula, we can find the current through all the capacitors. Substituting these current values in our equations, we will get 2 voltage equations. Now, applying Kirchhoff's voltage law in loop 1 and loop 2, we get Vc is equal to V3 and Vb is equal to V3 plus V2. Now, substituting Vc and Vb equation on our previous voltage equation, we will get these 2 final equations. Looking carefully at this equation, it is very clear that V1 is greater than V2, which is greater than V3. This means the voltage is not uniformly distributed across the disk. The disk nearest to the conductor has the maximum voltage across it. As we move towards the cross arm, the voltage across each disk goes on decreasing. Therefore, the unit nearest to the conductor is under maximum electrical stress and is likely to be punctured. In order to avoid this, we need more uniform distribution of voltages. This is usually expressed in terms of string efficiency. It is the ratio of voltage across the whole string to the product of a number of disks and the voltage across the disk nearest to the conductor. The greater the string efficiency, the more uniform the voltage distribution is. 100% string efficiency is an ideal case. This means the voltage across each disk will be exactly the same. Although it is impossible to achieve this, effort should be made to improve this value as close as possible. There are three main methods to improve string efficiency. That will be discussed in my next video. Bye, see you all there.